The Secret Covenant of the Jewish Secret Society, known as the Order of the Illuminati, posted on April 9, 2008, updated on October 31, 2011. Introduction. I can't guarantee the authenticity of this document, although the context pretty much describes the truth as it is. We don't know when it was written and exactly by whom, but it looks like it was composed by a British person if we look at the spelling of words, which is British English. This information was sent to me by someone who, for obvious reasons, wants to be anonymous. This person gave me this reply when I asked if he or she could verify the authenticity of it. The document was passed to me by a gentleman who has long been a researcher into these things, and it was meeting him that first caused me to search the web for more information. That's how I came across your website. I think he was afraid to let me see it at first, as he was unsure I could be trusted. He told me there are those who would kill to stop this information getting out. You will understand why I cannot reveal his name. I only know him by his first name anyway. He wouldn't reveal his surname. I believe he works as a member of an air crew, but precisely where, I don't know. He did tell me that someone on the inside had passed the information to him, but they could very well be dead by now. I have no doubt as to the authenticity of it, and hope we can broadcast it for far and wide. Once the word is out, they will never be able to suppress it, although they will try. Good luck with your work. We need more good men like you. I am hereby publishing it as it came to me, unaltered. I give the reader a chance to make up his or her mind regarding if this is a bogus or not. The Secret Covenant of the Jewish Secret Society, known as the Order of the Illuminati, issued under the supreme authority of the Jewish program and sanctioned by the Jewish Rothschild dynasty and the Jewish Rockefeller dynasty. The Secret Covenant. An illusion it will be, so large, so vast it will escape their perception. Those who will see it will be thought of as insane. We will create separate fronts to prevent them from seeing the connection between us. This very obvious is Trump and Deep State. They seem like to be in opposition, but actually they're working together. We will behave as if we are not connected to keep the illusion alive. Our goal will be accomplished one drop at a time, so as to never bring suspicion upon ourselves. This will also prevent them from seeing the changes as they occur. We will always stand above the relative field of their experience, but we know the secrets of the absolute. We will work together always and will remain bound by blood and secrecy. Death will come to who speaks. We will keep their lifespan short and their minds weak while pretending to do the opposite. Right now, our lifespan is short because all the chaos, all the disease, man-made weather, disaster, war, MSG, and all the poisonous chemical in our food, etc. So our mind's weak is through MSN, mainstream entertainment channels, social media, anything that is from the public channel. Bombarded us all the MK Ultra programming to control the minds of the public. We will use our knowledge of science and technology in subtle ways so they will never see what is happening. We will use soft metals aging accelerators and seductives in food and water, also in the air. They will be blanketed by poisons everywhere they turn. The soft metals will cause them to lose their minds. We will promise to find a cure from our many fronts, yet we will feed them more poison. So the soft metals that they're feeding us is from the chemtrail. Those metals actually is poisonous. On the other hand, it also can control our minds through 5G or any like satellite communication system. The poisons will be absorbed through their skin and mouths. They will destroy their minds and reproductive systems. From all this, the children will be born dead, and we will conceal this information. The poisons will be hidden in everything that surrounds us, surrounds them, in what they drink, eat, breathe, and wear. We must be ingenious in dispensing the poisons, for they can see far. We will teach them that the poisons are good with fun images and musical tones. Those they look up to will help. We will enlist them to push our poisons, which is those social media entertainers and those celebrities, politicians, and the powerful elites that own major businesses, etc. So they are the public speakers for this society. They will see our products being used in film and will grow accustomed to them and will never know their true effects. When they give birth, we will inject poisons into the blood of the children and convince them it is for their health, which is vaccine. We will start early on. When their minds are young, we will target their children with what children love most, sweet things, and also cartoons, animations, books, music, etc. And of course, in school. When their teeth decay, we will fill them with metals that will kill their mind and steal their future. When their ability to learn has been affected, we will create medicine that will make them sicker and cause other diseases, for which we will create yet more medicine. The medicine to help them, there are some medicines that boost your brain functions for like a certain period of time, like 24 hours or like 36 hours, just like Red Bull or like similar, something similar. We will render them docile and weak before us by our power. They will grow depressed, slow, and obese. And when they come to us for help, we will give them more poison. We will focus their attention toward money and material goods, so they never connect with their inner self. We will distract them with fornication, external pleasures, and games, so they may never be one with the oneness of it all. Their minds will belong to us, and they will do as we say. If they refuse, we shall find ways to implement mind-altering technology into their lives. We will use fear as our weapon. So mind-altering technology is the 5G, the chemtrail, the soft metal inside our body to respond to the 5G or any signals that can control the mind of the people. We will establish their governments and establish opposites within. We will own both sides. We will always hide our objectives but carry out our plan. They will perform the labor for us, and we shall prosper from their toil. Our families will never mix with theirs. Our blood must be pure always, for it is the way. So they are the offsprings of Satan, fallen angels. So that's why they need to preserve their own bloodlines. We will make them kill each other when it suits us. We will keep them separated from the oneness by dogma and religion. We will control all aspects of life and tell them what to think and how. We will guide them kindly and gently, letting them think they are guiding themselves. They will foment animosity between them through our factions. When a light shall shine among them, they shall extinguish it by ridicule or death, whichever suits us best. We will make them rip each other's hearts apart and kill their own children, which is divorce, cheating on each other, fornication, infidelity, etc. We will accomplish this by using hate as our ally, anger as our friend. The hate will blind them totally, and never shall they see that from the conflicts we emerge as their rulers. They will be busy killing each other. They will bathe in their own blood and kill their neighbors for as long as we see fit. We will benefit greatly from this, for they will not see us, for they cannot see us. We will continue to prosper from their walls and their deaths. We shall repeat this over and over until our ultimate goal is accomplished. We will continue to make them live in fear and anger through images and sounds. We will use all the tools we have to accomplish this. The tools will be provided by their labor. We will make them hate themselves and their neighbors. We will always hide the divine truth from them, that we are all one. This they must never know. They must never know that color is an illusion. They must always think they are not equal. Drop by drop, drop by drop, we will advance our goal. We will take over their land, resources, and wealth to exercise total control over them. We will deceive them into accepting laws that will steal the little freedom they will have, which is right now. And also, color is an illusion, which means we don't have white, black, yellow, pink, red, or you know, whatever skin color that we see. It's all an illusion. We all are one. The only difference is we live in different parts of the world. So they just using color to divide us. We will establish a money system that will imprison them forever, keeping them and their children in debt. When they shall band together, we shall accuse them of crimes and present a different story to the world, for we shall own all the media, which is the protest. We will use our media to control the flow of information and their sentiment in our favor. When they shall rise up against us, we will crush them like insects, for they are less than that. They will be helpless to do anything, for they will have no weapons. We will recruit some of their own to carry out our plans. We will promise them eternal life, but eternal life they will never have, for they are not of us. The recruits will be called initiates and will be indoctrinated to believe false rites of passage to higher ranks. Members of these groups will think they are one with us, never knowing the truth. They must never learn this truth, for they will turn against us, which is Freemason, Illuminati, etc., Skull and Bones, secret societies. For their work, they will be rewarded. with earthly things and great titles, but never will they become immortal and join us. Never will they receive the lights and travel the stars. They will never reach the higher realms, for the killing of their own kind will prevent passage to the realm of enlightenment. This they will never know. The truth will be hidden in their face, so close they will not be able to focus on it until it's too late. Oh yes, so grand the illusion of freedom will be that they will never know they are our slaves. When all is in place, the reality will have created for them will own them. This reality will be their prison. They will live in self-delusion. When our goal is accomplished, a new era of domination will begin. Their minds will be bound by the beliefs we have established from time immemorial. But if they ever find out they are all equal, we shall purge them. This they must never know. If they ever find out that together they can vanquish us, they will take action. They must never ever find out what we have done. For if they do, we shall have no place to run. For it will be easy to see who we are once the veil has fallen. Our actions will have revealed who we are, and they will hunt us down, and no person shall give us shelter. This is the secret continent by which we shall live the rest of our present and future lives, for this reality will transcend many generations and lifespans. This continent is sealed by blood, our blood. We the ones who from heaven to earth came. This continent must never ever be known to exist. It must never ever be written or spoken of, for if it is, the consciousness it will spawn will release the fury of the prime creator upon us, and we shall be cast to the depths from whence we came and remain there until the end time of infinity itself.